Good morning, class. How are you all? I hope you all are safe at home. Today, we are going to start with a new chapter in history, that is From Gathering to Growing Food. This chapter, the title itself says that gathering, it means they don't gather the rupees or clothes, but they used to gather the food and then they used to grow those food, whatever the grains they gathered. Fine. So here the title itself says that how the, you can say the Paleolithic or Old Stone Age people, how they used to gather and they used to grow the food. Okay. Next slide. In this chapter, in this lesson, we'll study varieties of food, the beginning of farming and herding, a new way of life, storing animals, finding out about the first farmer and herders towards a settled life, what about other customs and practice. Then we'll see a two closer look, one is Mehrgarh and another is Dajali heading. Okay, varieties of food. Fine. Here you can see from the PPT that plants that are grown, fine, and animals that are rare. Here the plants which we used to eat, say for example, you can say coriander, spinach, fenugreek, so on. Same way, animals that are rare, it means that the all the food, okay, non-vegetarian, you can say meat, pork and so on, etc. In the next slide, we will see the different plants, different conditions. Like different plants used to grow in a different season. According to the climate, the different plants used to grow. Fine, some of them need more water, some of them need less water. Water is essential for all the growing crops. Alright, so according to the climate, according to the place, it needs a different plants in a different condition. Different animals even prefer different environment. Sheep and goat can survive in a dry hill, whereas cattle need grassland to survive. So here we can say, in looking at the picture, it's very clear that different animals prefer different environment, right? Now how the beginning of farming and herding happens, how the people became farmer. This is very important flow learning. You all have to learn this, right? Suppose ki you can say that how people become a farmer, where the you can say plants were grown and seeds ripen, then it comes to the edible. It means the plant which is easily available and which is to be eat. Then seeds broke off, stalks fell on the ground, again new plants sprout from them. Then people protect the plants and from birds and animals. At that time they were not having any sort of ethics how to eat, fine, they just used to eat like that. They were not having a spoon, fork, nothing. They'll just eat the food in any ways. Then slowly and gradually they came to know ki wow, this is how the plants grow, and this is by this flow learning it is very much clear that how the plants used to grow. In the next slide we will see about a new way of life. Fine. Suppose ke you can say that they begin making a large clay pots, and even they used to wove basket, duck pits into the ground. At that time they were not having any sort of pots, fine, or any sort of storing material. So they used to clay pots, they used to wove the basket, and even they used to duck pits into the ground. Then people planted seeds and noticed that it takes some time to grow. This is again a whole procedure. They stay in the same place for a longer time. Why they used to stay? They look after the plants, they'll water, they're weeding, even they're driving away the animals and birds till the grains ripen. This way, how they become aware, they having awareness about how the plants used to grow. All right, now in the next slide we will see that how the old age people became old stone age people became the farmers. We have already seen. Now we'll see about the herders. Here the how people became herders. People used to protect these animals from the attacks. Animals were tamed means to make them pet. First animal was none other than but a dog. Other animals were encouraged to come near the camp. Sheep, goat, cattle and pigs ate grass and came near the camps. This is how they become a herders. You people, it's very clear that how the people become a farmers. Now it is very clear how the people become a herders. How they used to store the grain. Can you see the picture? See, first picture says that earthen or clay jars, even the pots they used to make. They were not having any ready-made shop that they go and bring those. They even used to, on below that, you can see a duck pits into the ground to store the grains. Here they used to duck their pits, fine, into the grounds and they used to store the grain. Even the people, see exactly opposite to the picture, even the people wove basket to store the grains. So these are the variety of how the people used to store their grains. How the people storing animals, people took animal of care. They used to take care because they were provided. Okay. Towards a settled life, slowly and gradually, now people become aware. Fine. So first how they become a farmer, then how they become the herders, then in the third slide how they used to grow the crops. Now they settle their life. Pit houses in Burza home, that is in Kashmir. The step lead the people into them, provide with, it has a such type of shelter which provide them in a cold weather. They using the cooking huts inside and outside the huts were found. Huts here, it means chulla. Fine. Here the huts, it means chulla. Fine. They were having both the ways. Suppose ke if at the time the people used to cook the food, and if all of sudden if snowfall started, then people will go inside and they'll start preparing or cooking the food. So people cooked both the ways, indoor and outdoor, according to the weather. Neolithic implement of stone, flint and horn. Can you see the picture? These are the various, fine, the, you can say the stone tools which they used to use at that time. Now tools, this is a comparison between a Paleolithic age and Neolithic age. You can see that Paleolithic, it means past old stone age, were using a simple shaped stone tools like cutter and hand axe. Also they've used sphere, tips and stick. Can you see the picture? And next, in the Neolithic age, of course, now in advance, fine, advanced shaped tools like bows and arrows and harpoons. Harpoon is a type, okay, of a tool. Also they use a sphere and tips. You can see the differentiate between both the tools. Characters of Neolithic tools and weapons and implement. They were polished to give a fine cutting edge. Mortar and pestle were used for grinding grains. Fine, mortars and pestle. Even today at our home also we used to, grind the grains or making a chutneys. Our dadima, surely they used to use this. Fine, many kinds of earthen pots have also been found. Sometimes decorated, they were used for storing things. You can see how beautiful they are decorated. But this is all in natural color, huh? They don't prefer, means at that time they were not having a kaolin or faber castell or any other sort of products. Fine, this is all in natural color. Pots were used for cooking food like rice, wheat and lentils. This were the such a earthen pot, in a such a way they made so strong that they use this, people use for cooking like rice, wheat and lentils. towards a certain life. They become weaving a cloth by using a different kind of material, whatever the material were available. They used to weave them. Can you see the picture? Picture itself says a clear idea about how they use a different kinds of material. What about other customs and practices? Many of these farmers and herders lived in a group called tribes and follow certain practice they may have exhibited earlier. The picture you can see, this are none other than but Paleolithic age or even you can say the old stone age people. A closer look, living and dying in Mehrgarh. Mehrgarh exactly, it is having a very fertile plain near the Bolan Pass, which is one of the most important route in Iran. It is one of the earliest village that we know about. One of the places where women and men learned to grow barley and wheat, and even they used to raise sheep and goat for the first time in this area. Bones of animals like deer, pig, sheep, goat, cattle were found. This is what a Mehrgarh is. Okay. Houses in Mehrgarh. Can you see what sort of houses? Fine. It is a four compartment sort of houses. Okay. Burial sites in Mehrgarh. Several burial sites have been found at Mehrgarh. In some cases, the dead person was buried with goats and sheep, which meant to serve as food in the next world. So many times, even we have heard or we came to know that the Raja or any of the person who used to die, they buried with all the things, whatever they were using. Maybe their pots, maybe whatever clothes, even the weapons. They think that when going from one place to another, they'll need on the way. Find this were their all imagination. Now that was a Mehrgarh. I hope Mehrgarh is clear. Now we come to the Dayajali heading. It's a site on the hills near a Brahmaputra valley, which is very near to the China and Myanmar. This all things you can see is found here. Have been found here. You can see this stone tool is or jadite. Jadite is a precious stone which is brought from China and which is found in China. Now points to remember. Children, you have to remember this point. And as a prep, this point you have to write twice in any of your book. Fine, either you write in your study book or whatever book is available with you. Our app, like ancestor, had to face many challenges from the climate, wild animals and from other human groups. They gradually transfer from nomads to hunter, to herders, to cultivator and to present modern men. Prehistory is the period of history before the invention of writing. Paleolithic age is also called Old Stone Age. In this age, people used to live like nomads. They live in a small hunting and gathering groups. People developed a spoken language, invented clothing, and used rocky overhangs and caves as shelter. They also learned to build fire for warmth, cooking, and light. In Neolithic period, people learned farming and settled themselves in permanent villages. They also learned to domesticate animals. Neolithic agriculture revolution was the change from nomadic to farming life. This led to the development of the civilization. Uses of grain as food lessened the dependence on animals. Grain were used as seeds to grow further crops. Thank you, students. Stay home, stay safe. Hereby, I am sending you the PDF of the chapter number 3 of history. If you feel any doubt, if you feel any confusion, feel free to message me. I am here to help you out anytime. All right. Thank you, class. Bye-bye.